Everyone loves lots of monitors. One of the most neglected points in this retina-happy world is retina's super clean, high-resolution displays come at a cost. This is commonly referred to as the retina tax. One of the more common use cases for modern systems is a dual display configuration.
Or in my case, well, you get the idea.
There are plenty of ways to get dual displays from your MacBook Air, MacBook Pro, or PC laptop. But what about performance after these displays have been set up? As with most things in computing, there are better and worst ways to do just about everything.
Take a look on Amazon. You'll see a whole bunch of stuff like this that'll essentially just take USB-C and with a little bit of conversion give you HDMI. This is highly inefficient because it doesn't make use of Thunderbolt 3's full throughput.
OWC recently released an extremely versatile product aimed at high-efficiency, high-performance display augmentation. It takes one Thunderbolt 3 port, and using the dedicated display port support built into Thunderbolt 3, outputs dual HDMI or DisplayPort 4K displays,
or a single 5K display at 60 frames per second if we're talking about the DisplayPort version, but I'm getting ahead of myself.
After the summary, I'll explain why I think OWC's approach to dual displays is an excellent mix of efficiency, flexibility, and price. Then I'll try to tackle as many "can this adapter do blank" questions as I can possibly come up with, and in doing so, we'll probably end up testing just about every monitor that I can find in the studio and probably at my house too. But first, a little bit about the specs. The adapter comes in two flavors, HDMI and DisplayPort. The HDMI variety outputs dual 3840 by 2160 displays at 60 frames a second. The adapter does this with full HDMI 2.0 spec compliance, ensuring both displays can do 4K with full HDR support. The DisplayPort version can also leverage Thunderbolt 3's ability to interleave DisplayPort channels to support either two 4K or a single 5K display. The DisplayPort variety has dual 4Ks outputting at a slightly larger 4096 by 2160 at 60 frames a second, and the 5K can output at 5120 by 2880 at 60 frames per second. Now let's talk about chipsets. The HDMI flavor has two chipsets, and the DisplayPort has one. Both flavors of the adapter use the same Thunderbolt 3 chipset that Intel developed when they designed Thunderbolt 3. In short, that means the most efficient possible conversion from Thunderbolt 3 to DisplayPort 1.2 possible. The HDMI flavor has one more conversion chipset to take the signal and bring it from DisplayPort to HDMI. OWC did this with the Parade PS176 hardware controller. The PS176 is so stable, it was the chipset used by the first VESA certified converters ever made. It's also the same chipset Samsung chose to power their desktop experience mobile devices. So if you've ever plugged a Samsung phone or tablet into HDMI, you've probably already used this chipset.
So what's the point of all this information about chipsets? Assuming computers have finite resources, and Thunderbolt is the most efficient I/O, and of course conversions done with stable hardware require less system resources under load, then greater efficiency between computers and displays mean more system resources dedicated to your tasks, and less overhead wasted by substandard methods of conversion. In this case, the and in that equation is the OWC Thunderbolt 3 converter.
But don't take my word for it. Let's get on to testing.
Here's what we tested. This time lapse shows all the combinations of the displays we tested, and to make things interesting, we did all of these tests without power cycling the MacBook Pro. As you can see, the results were flawless, no matter which combination of DVI adapters, resolutions, color gamuts, or pixel densities, every test was perfect.
So far, consider me thoroughly impressed. I thought at very least I would have to end up rebooting the MacBook Pro or something. HDMI conversions. Holy crap, and it worked perfectly. I love it. Look at that. Three monitors detected, and three monitors are good to go. There it is, showing up now. And it looks like dual HDMI 4K is giving me the option of outputting audio to either monitor because both of them are capable of supporting audio. Adherence to spec matters a whole bunch, and OWC has truly come through in spades.
4K displays are so pedestrian. Go with the DisplayPort version and you can use one 5K display.
At Nerds Limited, we have a crack marketing team. And one of the things that they've figured out is chipset discussions can get a little bit boring. So they hired a crack voiceover artist to be sure that you stay entertained. Take it away, Count Cluckula.
Ugh. Ugh.